thing that really, really got me fired up is when you start to study the sun. He is unbelievable, and it's unbelievably beautiful as well to look at. We sort of talked about not using what we called space funk, which was just beautiful things for the sake of it. And we talked more about beauty in science, so finding a beauty in reality. You don't reinvent every single thing. So you have an antique Victorian table, and then on top of that table you have an iPod. And those things live in the same world, because it's the curse of the designer to design everything.
The set designer does such a good job. It's not just half of a spaceship or three quarters of a spaceship. It's you know, 360 degrees. You're in space on a spaceship.
And there's a mix of contrasts or scales. We have a ship that is, in our terms, enormous. And within that ship, there are tiny spaces. There are like submarine-like spaces for the people to live in.
We went to a nuclear submarine in Fast Lane in Scotland. We tried to get on an oil rig as well, which felt like a similar conditions. People trapped together for 3 months in a working environment.
So you haven't got something that's thought through in the sense of beauty. It's a real machine of function. So in our ship, like for instance in the living quarters, you've got wiring and leads running across the bedrooms and stuff, so that there's always a sense that you will break the spaces with the veins of the ship, that the thing is living and working all the time. Danny was tending towards something blue-collar, that the ship was going to break down, that it was in our sort of scenario, we have a sense that the ship is a living thing, and that it breaks down, and that there is always that need to fix something, which is that human element, which makes more for a drama in space than a sci-fi movie.